I think enrichment activities in the summer are absolutely essential and critical. And it's actually related to this achievement gap issue that we're very concerned with in the United States. If we just think about the achievement gap in terms of socioeconomic status, we know that in the summers, low income, low socioeconomic status children fall behind in reading and in math relative to middle and upper socioeconomic status children. Well, one of the ways that we can try to address the problem is to simply ask the question, what do those middle class children do in the summers? Can we recreate that experience for children who are economically disadvantaged? And what we know from ethnographic research is that middle class parents do a lot of enrichment activities. Instead of giving the children simple worksheets about what they read, mom will have a reading group for her children, and the neighborhood children will attend that reading group, and they'll make reading fun. They'll ask all these questions that help, again, children understand the text, build background knowledge. Children go to summer camp. They get all kinds of experiences in learning using all of their senses and modalities that they otherwise wouldn't get in school. And so I think what we want to try to do in the summer is not just duplicate what children experience in the school year, but to actually expand the opportunities that they have to learn, the opportunities that they have to read new books. And I think that if we can do that through these kinds of enrichment programs, that would be an awesome accomplishment that children could experience. And it's just something that I don't think a lot of kids have an opportunity to participate in if their families, say, don't have the resources or the knowledge of what these programs are and, or how to get their children enrolled in these programs. One of the things that we have to try to do in the summer is to keep the learning faucet open. And the idea behind the learning faucet is that when kids are in school, school is what provides opportunities to learn, all the instruction that teachers provide, the books in the library. But in the summer, low-income children, as a result of living in disadvantaged homes and in disadvantaged neighborhoods, don't have the same opportunities that middle-income children have. So what that implies is that they'll have fewer books at home. Even if they want to read something, perhaps their parents can't buy them the book. So there's this kind of resource issue. But I think in addition to the resource issue, there's also the knowledge issue that low-income parents have the exact same values, again, from ethnographic research that middle-income parents have about wanting their children to succeed, wanting their children to do well in school, but they sometimes don't have the knowledge. And so in some very interesting ethnographic studies that I've read, one thing they found is that a low-income parent who doesn't have, say, the knowledge about finding the appropriate book for their child will buy their child Harry Potter, thinking that, well, all fourth graders read Harry Potter. The child realizes that this is way too hard, gets very frustrated, and doesn't enjoy, and the parent might say, you're lazy, you don't like to read. Well, it has nothing to do with the child's laziness, just that the parent didn't understand that you've got to be able to match the book to the reader. And many parents from disadvantaged backgrounds don't have that knowledge. And so the learning faucet, in my opinion, is really about both the resources, the learning resources at home, and also the knowledge that the parents have to make those resources available and accessible to the children. So I think there are potentially two ways to keep the learning faucet open. One is to give the parents more information about the kinds of programs that are available, especially at the public library, programs that might be occurring in their local school, even in churches, all kinds of informal educational settings that might have summer programs. We have to make sure that those parents have access to that information. But I think an equally important strategy is the child. Children have forms of capital, their own knowledge, their own dispositions, their motivations. And an equally important finding in research is that low-income children, just like middle-income children, are very interested in learning, are very curious, are willing to find programs on their own. And so I think an important strategy might be, say, at the end of the school year, have the public librarian from the local city or town come to school and explain to the children that there's this program, there's an incentive to read program. Have the chief of police and the chief of the fire station come to the school and explain that on these days, we're going to have these special activities to learn about our professions. In other words, directly inform the children about the many opportunities that exist in the summer. And I think we have to view children as having their own forms of capital that we can tap into to get them motivated about creating very enriching and stimulating summers.